10 men at the Etihad, they're champions with 18-year-old McNair at centre-half with Michael Carrick. Hasn't kicked the ball in 16 weeks. We've got Valencia playing right back. And we've got 19-year-old Luke Shaw at our defence. That is the defence taking on the champions at Etihad. And I... You can watch Sky Sports, you can watch Fox Sports, you can watch ESPN. You can analyse this game any way you want to. But unfortunately, there are just some stats that are just not counted. And there are some stats that aren't just measured. And I tell you what, if there was a stat for playing for your badge, really wanting this game, playing like an actual club, mate, it would have been, we would have broken some records today. I just couldn't be more prouder of being a United fan now today. Yes, we didn't get the 3 points against City, but my word, we made them look like chump change throughout that second half in bits and pieces. 10 men, mate, if this was City last year, if we had David Moyes, they would have put 6 or 7 past us. No, not today, not today. In that second half, we made them look like they had 10 men. They were on their back foot. Pellegrini taking off Aguero, bringing on Fernandinho. They're not even taking us, they're not even putting us to the sword. You know, they know that we're coming back. And I tell you what, I couldn't be more happier. You know, Louis van Gaal says it's going to take time. It's going to go, you know, take time for his philosophy and all this stuff. But I tell you what, games like today brings that philosophy so much more quicker. And you can really tell that we have come a long way since last season. Look, you just got to look at our last month. Every single game now we play, we push teams right to the end. We always look like we are going to score right at the end. Yes, inconsistent results, I've always said it, is going to happen all along this season. From August all the way to May, we are going to drop points that we are meant to be picking up all 3 points from. There are going to be games where we dominate and we don't pick up points. Today, I thought we definitely deserved a point. But unfortunately, an idiot Chris Smalling, has cost our side points today. One act of stupidness. And unfortunately, Louis van Gaal can't do nothing about that. What's that saying? You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make a horse drink water. And that's exactly the situation with Chris Smalling today. You can train Chris Smalling all you want. You can put him at the back. You can tell him about Aguero. What's he going to do? What's he not going to do, you know? But I tell you what, when he's out on the pitch and he's diving into stupid tackles against Jimmy Milner, where there is no need to be diving in like that recklessly. There's no need to be blocking the ball to Joe Hart. They weren't on the counter attack. Stupid acts like that cost us today. And unfortunately, that's out of Louis van Gaal's control. But let me tell you now, January is around the corner. And mark my word, if we don't make any signings for defenders, I'll be shocked. But you bet that there'll be defenders coming. And if we don't get that many defenders in January, there will be defenders coming in the summer. Don't worry about that. But anyways, I'll cover the game quickly. Both teams came out. We were a little underdone at the back with Valencia not starting. Both teams were nervous. We gave the ball a lot in the first, you know, few minutes, I thought. But other than that, guys, I thought we had a lot of possession, United, you know. Normally, City are the team that has a lot of the possession. But, you know, this was real different compared to the last few derbies. We had a lot more possession. To be fair, we didn't do much when we had possession, I'll be straight out honest, but we did have a lot of the ball, whereas City, they didn't have much of the ball, but when they did have the ball, they created chances. And I tell you what, De Gea, my word, we have got ourselves an unbelievable keeper here. David De Gea, he just made so many great saves. Aguero should have scored, but didn't. Navas should have scored, but didn't. But pretty much that first half was just all around Smalling's red card. Just the stupidest red card you will ever see. And he really let down his teammates, the fans, the club today. Chris Smalling, don't worry, I'm pretty sure he'll be disappointed. I'm not sure where that leaves him with his career now, because he's had so many chances now. I think with games like today, big mistakes like today, Louis van Gaal will know maybe he's not right for the club. But in saying that, Carrick, who hasn't kicked the ball in 16 weeks, comes on to play at centre back against Aguero. Came on. Anyways, half time came 0-0. Right, and I just want to say, City had some penalty calls. Yes, they did, but they were all little ankle knocks, tap of the toes here. There was no clear-cut penalties. You got to remember, the referee gets one look at this penalty call, and it's in fast motion. He hasn't got the technology like we do to watch it on replays and slow motion. He gets one quick look at it, and for me, yeah, they could have been penalties. Yes, they should have been penalties, but they weren't clear cut. No one took out Aguero's ankle where he made it out like Fellaini broke his ankle where he just barely touched his ankle. Yes, I would agree it was a penalty, but Aguero make it out like he just someone got a knife and just stabbed him in the ankle like he couldn't get up, and rightly so. I was so rapt when Fellaini went down and just gave it to him because, mate, there's one thing I can't stand, it's diving. I hate it when our players do it, Ashley Young, and I hate it when other clubs do it. And Aguero, mate, fucking, it's embarrassing. It's an embarrassment. But anyways, came out the second half and down to 10 men. Obviously, City, the first 5 minutes, mate, just came out and just went boom, boom, boom. I'm thinking, geez, this is gonna be a long second half. Rojo unfortunately got injured. Looks like he's dislocated his shoulder. If that's the case, he's gonna be out for 3 months. And it's such a shame. He's been our best defender all season. Definitely our best defender, our centre half. And he's gonna be a massive, massive loss to us. So 18-year-old Paddy McNair comes up, and Paddy, mate, he played an unbelievable game. He looked like he was playing at the back for years. He just looked so cool and calm on the ball. Just bring the ball out the fence. Tell you what, he looks much, much more comfortable on the ball than Chris Smalling does. But couldn't be more happy with McNair. So the inevitable comes. Aguero scores a goal. And you think when Aguero scores this goal, Clichy cuts it back to him. You think, right, that's it now. We're down to 10 men. City are going to put 4 or 5 past us. You just got that feeling. But for whatever reason, mates, it just did not happen. It did not happen. We showed some heart. We showed some ticker. We were working back. We were getting the ball. We were getting possession. And we were working ourselves back into this game. We were looking more dangerous as the game went on. And Van Persie up front, so isolated, worked his socks off today, created a few chances from nothing, created a few corners, and we're getting back into the game. And we were starting to look really good. And Pellegrini's seen this, but what do you do when you're Pellegrini? He takes off Aguero and brings on Fernandinho. Why? Because he knows we were working ourselves back into the game. Mate, I couldn't be more happier. Di Maria played fantastic. Wayne Rooney, mate, he's been out for a month. You could show his match sharpness wasn't all there today, but you could tell in the second half he was getting things together. Di Maria played good. Daily Blind and Marouane Fellaini were awesome today. I thought whoever won the midfield battle today was going to win this game. And to be fair, it didn't turn out like that. Yaya Toure played an outstanding game. But I also think Daily Blind and Marouane Fellaini were also just as good. But when you're down to 10 men, it's too hard. It's too difficult. But in saying that, guys, the goal never came. City won 1-0. But we push City right to the death. We look like back. We look like we're back. We look like the old Sir Alex Ferguson side that just 10 men doesn't matter. We will push right to the end. Doesn't matter who you are, Champions or your Burnley or your any other club, mate. We just and I'm just couldn't be more happier, more prouder to be a United fan. But like that, like saying all this, guys, inconsistent results are still gonna happen from now to the end of the season. We are gonna boss teams, but we are gonna drop points along the way. That is just the way it's gonna happen this season. And don't get me wrong, January is only around the corner, and I'll mark my words, mate. Louis van Gaal will sign defenders, And once we get, and once he gets the right defenders for us, imagine us what we're going to look like in a few seasons' time. I'm just so excited. I can't wait. We finally look like we're heading back in the right direction. And yeah, you can argue all you want about David Moyes. Yeah, he had more points this stage than this season than Louis van Gaal. But you know what the difference is? Even though Moyes had more points on the board, you can see we were on the decline. Yes, we don't have many points as we did last year, but you can see Louis van Gaal, we are coming back. We are working our way back up to the top. And that is the difference. Those are the stats you do not see on Sky Sports and on Fox Sports and all BT Sports, any program that you can get Gary Neville looking at the board and saying, oh, this and ran here and that did there. And you don't see the ticker the players have, the heart, the determination. You don't measure that. There is no stats for that. But boy, when it comes together, it shows strong. And it never showed stronger today. Every single player today, besides Chris Smalling, played for the badge, played for the club. And as fans, we couldn't be more prouder. And I tweeted this out. Yeah, City, walk away, 3 points. But today, lads, I think we were the real winners because we look like we're back. Back in the sense that there were signs where Manchester United were decreasing after Fergie, thinking, oh, geez, are they going to be the new Liverpool? Today, for me, proved that we are Manchester United and we will be okay. We're going to be fine. Things are going to be good, and I can't wait. Things are looking so good. Couldn't be more prouder to be a United fan. But anyways, lads, that's the end of the review. Please give this a thumbs up. Get your comments down below. What did you think of the game? Man of the match for my United's point of view. I would have to say, it's probably too hard. I thought Fellaini again. Who is Fellaini? Where's this guy been? The last three games, he has come on. And I think he's been our best player over the last three games. But Rooney was good. Van Persie was good. To be honest, I couldn't even give a man of the match today. Everybody who played, from Valencia to Luke Shaw to McNair, Carrick at the back, mate, Daley Blint, mate, we were all fantastic today. But just a shame we didn't get any points. But I can't wait for the return game at Old Trafford. That is going to be fantastic. But anyways, lads, like I said, give this a like, get your comments down below. Make sure you follow me on Facebook and Twitter and all those wonderful things. I'm your boy, QHS7. Take care and peace.